If you're new or recently started to work with Figma, I know that variants, instances, text, and Boolean properties can be a challenge. But with just a few steps to understand how this works, your life will become a lot easier. Let's have a quick look at what these terms are, and then we dive into creating a real component with those properties. So, variants are different states of a component. They allow you to group and organize similar components into a single container. Imagine a button with three different sizes, large, medium, and small. Instances are copies of the component you can reuse in your designs. They are linked to the main component and receive any updates made to the component. So if I duplicate this button here and change the icon, the root component is the same, but now with a new instance of the same component. Text property is the ability to change the text inside our component without changing the other instances that you can have around your app. And Boolean are properties that are used to set true or false values, allowing us to toggle attributes on or off. In this case, we can show or hide the icon. Sounds easy? Let's go and create our own. The first thing to do is to create a component. In this case, we will create a button. So I'll type here button large and hit Shift A to add auto layout. In case you want to know more about auto layout, watch the video appearing somewhere on top of the screen. Now we can add a fill color. I'll change the fill with this purple that I have here. We can also add some rounded corners. And the next step is to make it a component. So if you go here on top and click in this icon, you will turn the button into a component. And this is our button component. Next up, we can rename the frame to button. Now, let's say that in some screens of our site or app, we have this button with an icon. You can simply copy an icon inside. So I will go here to my local component page, which we usually call the design system library, and I will copy this one and go back to my button component and paste the icon inside of it. Now, variants. Your website or app will work on desktop and mobile devices, and you want to create different button sizes to adapt to each case. So this is where variants are helpful, because I will now create a button medium and small from this one. If you take a closer look here on top, we have the icon Add Variant, and if you click, you get another button below that one. And if you click again, you have now three buttons. Let's change the text to button M, and this one to button S. Cool, so if you look closely to the right panel, you can see that you have this properties section, and if you click in this edit icon, we can see the names of our properties, and we should rename to be more understandable to us. So let's rename this property to button size, and then the values of these properties will be button large, button medium, and button small. Now, if you duplicate one of these buttons, you may see in the right side panel the property, and you can already switch between the variants. Pretty cool. Now, for these examples, let's use the icon instances. Imagine that in some screens, you want to display the button with text and icon. In other screens, only the text, and on some occasions, only the button. If you click in the icon and look at the side panel, you have here the name of the icon component, and right after it, you have this icon to apply instant swap property. So if you click, you get this pop-up, and you may change the name, so let's change to icon, and you can also set the instance by default. So in this case, I want to be share icon. Cool, so now we need to apply these settings to the other two buttons. In this case, we have only two more to update, but imagine you have a set of 20 components to update. If you look carefully, when I hover the button, you see this icon here, which means if I click it, it will select all components that are duplicated. And we can now click here in the right panel to apply the instance swap icon, and both will be updated. That's so awesome. Now, if we duplicate the button here, you may see that you can change the button size, but also select which icon you want to see, regardless of the variant you choose. Very handy. To apply text property, it's very similar to icons. So if we click here on text and look at the right panel, you may find here the text with this icon right here that says create text property. And in here you can change the text that in this case I think it makes sense to be colored text. But the value now we can change to button to be our default text. Now just do the same to the other text layers. Okay, now let's test and drag here a copy of this button, and we now are able to change the text here in the new property we've just created, and we can rename it to like this video. Did you catch it? Let me follow up this moment, and if you are enjoying the video and you are not yet subscribed, we will be very grateful if you subscribe and like the video, because it will help us a lot to keep doing videos like this. Okay, next up, it's Boolean. Boolean properties are used to set true or false values, allowing us to toggle attributes on or off. So in our case, let's say that we want to show or hide the icon of or the text. If you select the text and see here in the right panel on layer, you may find this icon to create a Boolean property. And when we click, we can change the property name. So we can type text visibility and set the value to true, because right now we want the text visible, and you have now this purple tag here. Then let's apply the same properties to the other button variants. And now if I pull over a copy here, you see this new property which has a toggle to make the text visible or not. Okay, so we have defined Boolean properties to text. We can do the same process to icons. So let's create a new Boolean property by selecting the icon, and instead of selecting the text visibility that we created for text, we will create a new one and called it icon visibility. But now I want that the default is false, and set the same properties again to other variants. So let's test the button now with all properties created, and you can see that we can change the button size, we can change the icon, we can show or hide the text, and also show or hide the icon. And that's it. Was this helpful? I really hope you enjoy and learn from it. Leave your like and subscription here in the channel, and catch you up in the next video. Thank you and have a great day.